Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to discuss the question and answers of the poem The Wild Swans at School. Explanation video is already there up on the channel. I will post the link of those videos in the description box. You can go and check. Let's quickly start. First, we have some true false with us. So let's start. First is, it was spring when the poet saw the swans. It is false. It was not spring season, it was autumn season. The poet saw them in the month of October at dawn. In the month of October in the morning? No, this is false. The poet counted 50 swans. This is also false. There were 59 swans. The poet had visited the lake before. Yes, he was not the first time visitor. The swans' hearts have grown old with time. That is false. They are still very energetic and passionate. Opportunities for passion and conquest still wait for the swans, which is absolutely true. Okay. Now we have antithesis. First says, under the October twilight, the water mirrors a still sky. So which water is being spoken about in these lines? यहाँ पर कौन से पानी की बात हो रही है? And we have to explain the figure of speech which is used here. So the water of a lake in the woods, in the forest at Cool Park is being spoken about in these lines. The figure of speech used is a metaphor. Why? Because we are comparing the water of the calm lake reflecting the clear sky to the surface of a mirror. So the calm lake is reflecting the clear sky. There is no movement in the water of the lake and it is looking like a mirror which is giving the reflection of clear sky. So yahan par jo pani hai lake ka, usko kiske sath compare kiya gaya hai? Mirror ke sath. Next is, what did the poet see immediately after this? Where did he see them? So he saw 50 swans, 59 swans on the lake surface among the stones. Kya dekha tha? Swans ko dekha tha. How had the poet described the land around the lake in the previous lines? The woods were beautiful in the orange tones of autumn. Yani jo forest hai wo orange tha, trees the uske wo orange the because it was autumn season. And the woodland paths were no longer lush and green but were ड्राई. सो ऑटम सीजन में क्या होता है? ग्रास नहीं होती है. सो जो पाथ था टुवर्ड्स द लेक वो बिल्कुल भी ग्रीन नहीं था, इट वॉज ड्राई. हाउ इज द लैंड एंड लेक कॉन्ट्रास्टेड? दोनों के बीच में क्या डिफरेंस दिखाया है? सो लैंड वॉज पीसफुल एंड ब्यूटिफुल इन द ऑक्टोबर ट्वाइलाइट. देर वॉज एब्सोल्यूट स्टिलनेस इन द वुड्स. द लेक वॉज इन कॉन्ट्रास्ट ब्रिमिंग विद लाइट ड्यू टू द मूवमेंट ऑफ swans. So jo land tha it was very quiet, there was no movement. In contrast, yani on the other hand, uske bilkul ulta, jo lake hai usme bahut zyada movement thi. It was moving because of the swans. The water was moving, later on it was moving because of the swans. Second, the 19th autumn has come upon me since I first made my count. How old had the poet been when he had first seen the swans? So what was the age? He was 19 years old when he had first seen the swans. What did the swans do as the poet was counting them? So swans ne kya kiya jab poet unko count kar raha tha? Poet, before he could count the swans, they suddenly flew up into the air and scattered in a circular manner. So poet jab unko count hi kar rahe the, tab kya hua? Birds uthi, they suddenly rose up into the air and in a circular motion mein fly karna shuru kar diya. Which word in the stanza means a circular motion? Kaun sa word hai jiska meaning hai circular motion? Did the swans rise into the sky together? Yani sari swans ek saath udi thi ya alag alag karke? We have to quote the line in the stanza which indicates this. So the words wheeling and ring in the stanza suggest a circular motion. Wheeling and ring, these are the two words which tell us that the bird started flying in a circular motion. And yes, the swans rose into the sky together as suggested by all suddenly mount. ये जो यहाँ पर लाइन है इससे हमें ये पता चलता है दैट द बर्ड्स स्टार्टेड फ्लाइंग टुगेदर इन द स्काई ऑल सडनली माउंट. सो ऑल यानी सारी बर्ड्स एंड सडनली मीन्स अचानक से, माउंट यानी राइज इन टू द एयर. नेक्स्ट, आइडेंटिफाई द साउंड इमेजरी इन द स्टैंजा फ्रॉम विच द अबव लाइंस आर टेकन. सो साउंड इमेजरी, the sound imagery is when you are able to imagine a sound from a word. So sound imagery in the stanza is evident, that means we can clearly see it with the word clamorous or noisy, indicating that the wings made a loud din, loud noise as the swans rose high in the air. Imagine karke dekho, bahut sari birds hain, ek saath agar wo udna shuru kar de, आपने पिजन्स को देखा होगा ऐसा करते हुए, सो आवाज आती है. सो द वर्ड क्लैमरस, दिस इज द वर्ड विच सजेस्ट द साउंड इमेजरी. हम इमेजिन कर पा रहे हैं कैसे सारी बर्ड्स एक साथ उड़ी होंगी. द इमेज दैट कम्स टू द माइंड इज ऑफ अ काम डिस्क्राइब्ड अप टू दिस पॉइंट बीइंग सडनली शैटर्ड बाय द लाउड फ्लटरिंग ऑफ द विंग्स. जैसे हमने ट्रू फॉल्स में पढ़ा था, जो लेक वाटर था वो बिल्कुल काम था, इट वॉज नॉट मूविंग, बट जैसे ही स्वान्स वहां से उड़ना शुरू करती हैं, दिस कामनेस वॉज शैटर्ड बिकॉज ऑफ द लाउड फ्लटरिंग ऑफ द विंग्स. फ्लटरिंग यानी जो मूवमेंट होता है विंग्स का एंड द साउंड मेड बाय इट. क्लियर. नेक्स्ट, आई हैव लुक्ड अपॉन दोज ब्रिलियंट क्रीचर्स एंड नाउ माई हार्ट इज सोर. How was the poet feeling at this time? So the poet was feeling sad at that time. He realized that much had changed since his first visit. He had grown old and this realization of lost youth made him sad. So poet jo tha wo is time pe bahut sad tha and he realized that a lot of things had changed since his first visit. Jab first time yahan aaya tha aur ab mein bahut change hai. He had grown old and this realization of lost youth made him sad. Jab unko realize hua ki birds abhi bhi utni hi energetic hain aur passionate hain, but he had become old. So this thought had made him sad. How had the poet changed since the first time he had seen the swans and what does it indicate? So the poet realized that 19 years had passed since his first visit and everything had changed. Usko realize hua ki 19 years already pass ho chuke hain and now everything had changed and he walked with a lighter tread and unki jo walk thi usme bhi change aaya tha, that he had become older and he was not as flexible as his first visit. So symbolically this indicates the fleeting nature of life. यानी लाइफ के जैसे जैसे ह्यूमंस लाइफ में एज होते जाते हैं, उनकी जो एनर्जी है, उनकी जो एज है वो बढ़ती है, उनकी एनर्जी रिड्यूस होती है. दिस इज व्हाट वी लर्न हियर. हाउ डज द पोएट गो ऑन टू एक्सप्लेन दैट द स्वान्स हैव नॉट चेंज्ड. अपने बारे में तो बता दिया दैट हाउ हैज ही चेंज्ड. लेट्स रीड अबाउट द बर्ड्स. सो स्वान्स वर अनवेरीड, वो बिल्कुल भी ओल्ड नहीं हुई थी. उनके जो हार्ट्स थे दे हैव नॉट ग्रोन ओल्ड, दैट मीन्स उनके अंदर अभी भी वही सेम एनर्जी थी. दे स्टिल हैड अपॉर्चुनिटीज फॉर पैशन एंड कंक्वेस्ट, दैट मीन्स दे स्टिल हैड लव फॉर फ्लाइंग एंड वाटर एंड दे वर स्टिल सर्चिंग फॉर फूड लाइक एवरी टाइम, मीनिंग दे स्टिल हैड होप. दे स्टिल हैड होप ऑफ फ्लाइंग लाइक फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम दे हैड होप ऑफ being in the lake with other swans, with their family. This shows that the swans remained the same since the poet's last encounter with them. So, यहाँ पर एक चीज के बारे में आपको ध्यान रखना है कि जो हम swans की बात कर रहे हैं, ऐसा नहीं है कि 19 years पहले जो swans थी अभी भी वही swans हैं. यहाँ पर हम same species की बात कर रहे हैं. Swans यानी जो swans उस time थी वैसी ही swans, similar looking swans इस time है, बट उनके अंदर जो एनर्जी है वो अभी भी वही है. 19 इयर्स बाद भी कुछ चेंज नहीं हुआ था, वही पानी था, वैसे ही बर्ड्स थी, दे हैड द सेम पैशन, उसी तरीके से एनर्जी थी उनके अंदर, बट पोएट हैड चेंज्ड. पोएट के अंदर चेंज आ गया था, लेकिन नेचर में कोई चेंज नहीं आया था. क्लियर? सो यहाँ पर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द फ्लीटिंग नेचर ऑफ यूथ, जो हमारी एज के साथ साथ हमारी जो यूथफुलनेस है, ह्यूमंस जो हैं वो मॉर्टल है. सो जो हमारी यूथफुलनेस है, जो हमारी एनर्जी है, दैट रिड्यूसेस एज के साथ साथ. बट नेचर के साथ ऐसा नहीं है, नेचर अपने आप को रिप्लेनिश करता है. वॉट डू द स्वान सिंबलाइज इन द पोएम? इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन. द स्वान सिंबलाइज इटर्नल ब्यूटी इन नेचर एंड लव. हमारी लाइफ में जो ब्यूटी है वो स्वान सिग्निफाई कर रही है, नेचर में जो ब्यूटी है, जो लव है. वाइल एवरीथिंग एल्स अराउंड द पोएट सीम्स टू बी डाइंग एंड एजिंग, जैसे जो ट्रीज हैं वो भी क्या हो रहे हैं, रिप्लेनिश कर रहे हैं अपने आप को, ऑटम सीजन में रिप्लेनिश करते हैं. जो ड्राइड और जो डेड लीव्स हैं वो दे फॉल ऑफ, एंड देन स्प्रिंग सीजन आता है, समर सीजन आता है, अगेन दे रिप्लेनिश. सो पोएट के आसपास जितनी भी चीज़ें हैं वो एज हो रही हैं, लेकिन जो स्वान्स हैं वो अनचेंज्ड हैं, दे आर फुल ऑफ लाइफ. दे आर अ प्रूफ दैट नेचर कंटिन्यूज टू रीजनरेट इवन एज लिविंग बींग्स डाई. सो लिविंग बींग्स जो है वो मॉर्टल हैं, लेकिन जो नेचर है वो अपने आप को रिप्लेनिश करता है, रीजनरेट करता है, बी इट ट्रीज, बी इट वाटर, बी इट बर्ड्स. सो वो एक नेचर का पार्ट है. बट ह्यूमन बींग्स जो है वो रीजनरेट नहीं करते, वी टेक बर्थ एंड देन आफ्टर अ पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम वी डाई. ओके? From the second to the last stanza, poet describes the movement of the swans as they take off from the lake, fly in the air, swim in the water. So we have to quote these lines and explain them ki kaun-kaun se lines mein movement explain kiya hai. So movement of the swans taking off from the lake and their flight are described in the lines. All suddenly mount and scatter, wheeling in great broken rings upon their clamorous wings. Meaning kya hai? That the swans fly up together from the lake and they scatter in the air in big circular movements. In the next stanza, the poet recalls their wings flapping and the sound is made like the ringing of a bell. So the first time on the shore, the bell beat of their wings above my head, trod with a lighter tread. This is the line. And in the last stanza, he is describing the graceful movement of the swans, unwearied still. That means they're not tired at all. They still have the same energy. Every time you see the birds, they have the same energy. So they paddle in the cold, but now they drift on the still water. I hope it's clear. Next, how has the poet contrasted the way his life has changed while that of the swans hasn't in 19 years? So poet ne kya difference dikhaya hai? The poet recognizes that he has grown old and that it is the twilight of his life. It is the ending of his life. Jaise twilight kya hota hai? Wo time hota hai jab sunset ho raha hota hai. That is twilight. So he is on the verge of his life getting ended. He has become old. His life has changed in 19 years. He is no longer energetic and youthful. His heart is sore, that means he is sad, and he looks tired without any hope. That means he has lost hope of replenishing his life. On the other hand, the swans are full of life, noisy as before, and live without worrying. They have each other's company and still have passion for life. Their hearts have not grown old. This is the contrast that the poet wants to show us. Dusre time pe, dusri taraf, jo swans hain, they are full of life, noisy as before. Unke andar koi change nahi aaya. They have each other's company, they still have passion for life, they are still very youthful, they still have the same energy. But the poet has grown old. So this is the contrast, this is the difference that the poet wants to show us. Last question. What does the poet wonder about the swans doing in the future? The poet wonders, when one day the swans fly away from him, or even when he no longer comes to see them, will they continue to do what they have always done? Last stanza mein poet kya soch rahe hain? He is wondering, he is thinking to himself that ek din jab main shayad yahan nahi aaunga, to kya birds waise hi udti rahengi, yani unme koi change aayega? He wonders, where will they build their homes? among which reeds or which lake's edge or pool. And he also thinks about where are they going to build their homes. यानी किसी लेक के आसपास होगा, किसी पूल के आसपास होगा, कहाँ पर होगा? So he is wondering, अगर मैं यहाँ पर नहीं आता हूँ या observers नहीं आते हैं, तो क्या nature वैसे ही रहेगा? So yes, nature अपने आप को change नहीं करता, nature will remain same, no matter the observer is there or not, कोई देखने वाला है या नहीं, nature तो वैसे ही रहेगा, right? So this is what he wonders in the last stanza of the poem. So we are done. Now we have vocabulary exercises. In vocabulary exercises, the first one is rhyme scheme. So rhyme scheme is जो rhyming words आपके किसी भी line के end में आते हैं, they form the rhyme scheme as it is given in the book also. So the 19th autumn has come upon me. Last word यहाँ पर क्या है? Me. In this line, the last word is count. Me and count do not rhyme. So यहाँ पर हमने अलग-अलग letters दिए हैं A, B. Next, finished. दोनों पिछले दोनों वर्ड से राइम नहीं हो रहा. माउंट, माउंट पहले था, सेम लेटर हमने यहाँ दिया. रिंग्स, नॉट राइमिंग, नेक्स्ट लेटर. विंग्स, रिंग्स, विंग्स राइम करते हैं, सो डी. सो यहाँ पर राइम स्कीम क्या होगी? ए बी सी बी डी डी. लेट्स डू दिस एक्सरसाइज. वी हैव आइडेंटिफाइड द राइम स्कीम इन द फॉलोइंग स्टैंजास. ही गिव्स हिज हार्नेस बेल्स अ शेक टू आस्क इफ देयर इज सम मिस्टेक. शेक मिस्टेक, इज इट राइमिंग? आप सोचिए. शेक मिस्टेक. स्वीप फ्लेक. सो शेक मिस्टेक स्वीप फ्लेक. यू थिंक द राइम स्कीम विल बी ए ए बी ए. वो क्यों होगा? शेक मिस्टेक, ए के आवाज आ रही है, सो ए ए. Sweep is different, so B. And flake, again A. So A, A, B, A. I hope it's clear. Next one. C, might. C ke liye hum A likhenge. Might ke liye we will write B. Make. It's not rhyming. So C, bright, might. It's rhyming B. Was, not rhyming, so D. And night, bright and night. It's rhyming. So the rhyming scheme will be A, B, C, B, D, B. I hope it's clear. Next, we have figurative language. That means the words or phrases which we use so that the reader is able to imagine the scene, the situation being told by the author or a poet. So we have these lines here. Let's see which figurative language is used. Now they drift on the still water. What has been used here? It means the swans glide gracefully on the calm waters of the lake. यहाँ पर क्या मीनिंग है इसका? जो swans हैं, they very gracefully move on the calm water of the lake. The swans delight men's eyes. What is the meaning? The graceful beauty of the swans is a beautiful sight, is a beautiful scene to watch, which captivates human beings across time. That means you are mesmerized. आप मंत्रमुग्ध हो जाते हो. आपको बहुत अच्छा लगता है birds को देखना. Swans तो वैसे ही बहुत beautiful होती हैं. This is the 13th summer of my life. इसका meaning क्या होगा? That he was 13 years old. They paddle in the cold companionable streams. इसका meaning क्या है? That the swans paddled in the cold streams. जो swans हैं वो ठंडे पानी में paddle कर रही हैं. But the warmth of the companionship, वो जो लव है उनके सबके बीच में, जो birds हैं वो group में चलती हैं हमेशा swans. So उनके बीच में जो warmth है, उस वजह से उनको वो ठंडा पानी feel ही नहीं होता. They don't feel the cold sensation of the water because they are moving together and the companionship, the love between them gives them warmth. The birds climb the air. What is the meaning? That the swans flew up into the air. I hope all the questions and answers are clear to you. In case you still have any doubt, comment box is always there. You can ask. Okay? Goodbye.